Well, my work is all very carefully planned. There's very little spontaneity about it. Anyone that knows anything about painting can look at it and tell that. I use a camera a great deal in my work when I'm going out into the field. I do a lot of sketching, but the camera has become an important tool to me, and I think to many other artists also. Then I'll do a quite detailed value drawing in pencil of the composition prior to the painting. And the painting actually comes from these little drawings that I do. There's some of them in my show, which is hanging now.
Your paintings reflect a great deal of realism. Quite frankly, the pictures that people can look at and admire. Do you feel any reason to defend this type of art?
Well, I don't think it needs to be defended, actually. But a lot of people do criticize realism today. I don't see where realism should be any less creative than any other form, and has many more problems in being creative because you have the competition of the camera constantly at your hand. So you have to seek new approaches and new methods of expressing the things in realism that you feel.
Well, what has been the reaction of the public towards your paintings?
Well, I feel very fortunate. The public has seemed to accept them rather well. We had a marvelous turnout for my opening the other night, and I think generally the people like them. Of course, everybody isn't going to like them. You're going to have probably as many don't like them as do, but that doesn't interfere with your painting. You don't paint for what people like anyway. You paint for what you feel and what you want to express.
Who buys your painting, Rolland?
Well, that's hard to say also, but anybody, I think, that gets something out of it buys it, no matter what their profession is, what their class in life is. If they get something out of it, they'll buy it. This has been our experience so far.